Hey guys, this is all about triangle inequalities. This is going to be your practice for the weekend. So your practice, how you're going to do this, is a 5-3 and 5-5 study guide. It's that packet. By the end of this video, you're going to know how to rank the sides from least to greatest. You're going to determine whether the lengths of a triangle or the side lengths make a triangle, and find a range of values that of the lengths could be. So the first thing we have to talk about is triangle inequalities. Inequalities are those less than or greater than symbols, and they help us rank the sides and angles by size. So if we know all the sides of a triangle, we can tell you the size of the angles relative to each other. And also, if we know how big the angles are, we can figure out which is the longest side, shortest side, that sort of thing. So, if we look at our notes, okay, the triangle inequality says we can tell that the longest side is across from the largest angle. So, the smallest side is across from the smallest angle. And we can see that if we take out Geometer Sketchpad, okay, the largest side here is FD, okay, so it's that side right there, okay? And if you notice, angle E is the biggest. It's 86, okay? So this angle is across from the largest side. Also, DE here is the shortest side. So that's this. So F over here across from it is the smallest angle. Now, as I change this triangle, okay, now if you look, angle D is the biggest angle by far, and now EF is the largest side. Also, the smallest angle is angle F, and the shortest side is DE. All right, so largest side across from the largest angle, smallest side across from the smallest angle. So if I'm rating the sides, or so 6, 7, 9. So if I'm listing the angles in order from smallest to largest, okay, this is my smallest side. So angle T is my smallest angle. 7 is my next. So angle R is my medium, okay? And then 9 is my largest side, so angle S is my biggest, okay? And then here I'm listing the sides in order, from shortest to longest. So my smallest angle is 20. So my smallest side is going to be CB. So I would write CB. My next biggest angle is 35. It's angle C. So my side AB is going to be my middle. And then my largest angle is 125. So that's angle B. So my largest side is going to be AC. So it's really easy to rate which is going to be the bigger, which is going to be the smaller. So the next few are just examples of this. So it says list the angles and the sides. So here the sides are easy. RS is the smallest. ST is the next one, and RT, okay? So then, as I rate this, okay, RS is the smallest, so angle T is the smallest angle, okay, then angle R, and then angle S. So that's all I have to do with this. The only thing is I gotta remember the angle notation and the segment notation. Here, angle T is the smallest, angle R is the middle, angle S is the biggest. So now I'm rating the sides. SR is going to be the smallest side, ST is going to be the middle one, and RT is going to be my biggest side. And that's all I have to do for triangle inequalities. So you can complete the rest. Now, the other part of this is the what it makes to a triangle, okay? So the sum of any two sides of a triangle have to be greater than the third side. So if we go back to Geometry Sketchpad, okay, I'm going to move these angles. I'm going to hide these angles here, okay? No matter how I move this, okay, whatever this triangle is, my two smallest sides are going to add up to be bigger than my third side. The only time that doesn't happen is if I drag this point, if I can drag this point, boom. Okay. Is that a triangle? That's a straight line. Okay. Remember, a triangle is formed by three non-collinear points. So these points cannot be on the same line. So this third point has to be over here, which means that the two smaller sides have to add up to be the larger side, to be bigger than the larger side. So if I go back to my examples on my notes, these are my two smaller sides. So 3 plus 4, is that greater than 6? Okay, 7 greater than 6? So yes, it can form a triangle, okay? 6 plus 9, is that greater than 15? Well, 6 plus 9 is 15. They're equal. That means that it's not a triangle, okay? 8 plus 8, greater than 8? Yes, it is. 16 is greater than 8, okay? While 4 plus 8, is that greater than 16? 12 is not greater than 16, so it's not a triangle. And that's all you have to do to figure out if these three sides are going to add up to be a triangle. Okay. The next part shows you how to deal with a triangle, and I only give you two sides, and you need the range of the sides. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at this triangle right here. As you can see, as I move this around, I've locked AC to be 8 centimeters and AB as 3. So they're not going to change. The only thing that's going to change is this purple line, this BC line. You can see the measurement right here. So it could be a whole lot of things. But what happens is, once I get to a certain point, boom, now it's going down, right? So that line maxes out at 11 centimeters. The purple line then is minimized right here at 5 centimeters. Now, at 5 and at 11, they're not triangles. But a little bit above it, they are triangles. Okay? A little bit above the 5, that is a triangle. So it can't be 5, it can't be 11. But the range is in between that 5 and 11. So I'm going to say 5 is less than x, which is less than 11. You notice it can't be equal, because if it's equal, then it's not a triangle. But if it's a little above, okay, and it's a little more than 5, then it is a triangle. So when we go back to this, and it gives you a triangle that has 5 and 8, okay? All I do is I say, all right, to find the minimum value, what's 8 minus 5? That's 3, okay? What's the maximum? 8 plus 5. That's going to be 13. So somewhere in there, from 3 to 13, that's going to be my other side. Because if I take any number in between 3 and 13, and I add it to 5, that's going to be bigger than 8. So here, I give you 1 and 6. Again, I do the same thing. What's 6 minus 1? What's 6 plus 1? So anywhere in between 5 and 7, that's going to give me a real triangle. So then you guys can do the rest. The hinge theorem relates two things, two triangles, okay? You notice here, this side is congruent to this side is congruent to this side, but these angles are different. 60 is less than 80. That means I can relate the sides. As long as I have two triangles and the sides are equal, I can relate their angles. So basically what I'm doing is one angle's like this, one angle's a little bit open. So now I can say, okay, RT, because it's across from the 80 degree, has to be bigger than AC, because it's across from the smaller angle. And I can also do the same thing relating the sides. You notice that there's the same markings here. Okay, but 36 is bigger than 33. So angle M is greater than angle R. That's all you're doing, is you're relating the two sides. So in this case, okay, compare G, F, and F, E. Well, I have to look, okay? GF is across from the 28, FE is across from the 22. 28's greater than 22, so GF is bigger. Okay, now here I have to relate angle ABD, this angle right here, and angle CBD, this angle right here. Well, ABD is across from the 16. CBD is across from the 13. So that ABD has to be bigger because it's across from the bigger side. And that is how you do the hinge theorem. That is how you do triangle inequalities. So complete this packet. Come in with questions on for our next class.